Hello, YouTube. This is King Harp. I'm back with you guys. You know, I talk about things as my passion tells me to. Because everybody's authentic, but we all headed for the same things, right? We all going in the same direction, but we all authentic. Today, my discussion is going to be about, again, illegal immigration and these groups and what they do. You see, the reason I talk about these groups is because I do duties, I work, I perform, I'm a professional, and I'm among a lot of different elements. And I'm among these groups, and I understand it. And I am the American Negro, I'm a descendant of slavery, and I'm a foundation of Black America. But I'm going to tell you something. This situation that we're in is not about liking anybody, it's not about hating anybody, but it's about being disdained in terms of something bigger and a more relevant space. And that's politics and what they're allowed to do and what they are doing. And first, I want to let you know, these groups are not necessarily innocent people. Now, they carry on in benevolence exchange in terms of being people. I mean, you may get a cupcake from your coworker who's Latino at work. You may even call her mama because she's older. You may even get things done and you look at people as friends and you socialize and all that. That has nothing to do with the price of tea. And I think us Black people don't understand that. And we have to understand self-preservation. Well, they're over here eating off our plate. And what they've done is they've vanished their own home and abandoned their own home because we have a developed society which the slaves have built and our economy dollar which the slaves have put into in a subservitude way. And they are over here accessing capital, even the Mexicans. Not just the Sicilians and not just the people from Iraq, not just those people. You know, you got the Arabs, not just those where they have gas stations and capital and now they're buying this and that and owning this and that and, you know, the East Indians or what have you, owning stuff, running businesses around Black communities, the communities of the American Negro, the concentration camps called the Hood. You see, they are able to access a certain thing because they have white skin or have access whiteness. And they are trying to, white people are trying to upgrade the numbers in terms of their existence according to what's happening to them. This is political. And to continue to deny and demise the American Negro of its capital and the things that we're supposed to access in terms of inheritances and other people coming here receiving reparations. Now, reparations is basically a protected class citizenship in terms of the political arena. So when you get reparations, the Latino community or what have you, and when they receive that, what they're receiving is a protected class. Well, that's where sanctuary cities come from, sanctuary cities. That's kind of a reparations. And then you have the banks, which are in business camaraderie with these guys, and they give them loans according to what their value of owning businesses. And the main thing that the Mexican does is they own like construction sites, plumbing sites, different things of that sort. So those are businesses. Now, we can continue, and I'm going to give you a little bit more about this. In terms of owning businesses, we haven't even talked about the East Indians and what they own. But in terms of owning businesses, you got people who are owning those businesses that are inside a developed society, which was built by slaves and built and ran and constructed by the American Negro, also along with white colonizers, white people that are in America. And they are here receiving the opportunities, not that they built anything, but receiving the opportunities that they can now trade inside business and in the banks because the United States is a business. So therefore, the banks are leaning toward them in terms of, okay, Pedro wants to have a construction site. 9 times out of 10 is because of his group, he's going to do this. He's adjacent to this type of skill set. Also, then he knows somebody that's doing it also. So then he gets to have $20,000 to start the construction site. And one of those banks is not Bank of America, but Wells Fargo. We have the proof that Wells Fargo allowed them to have $145 billion in loans in 2016. And blacks complained. And then blacks got $65 billion the following year. Well, see, we had to complain to have that type of respect. And see, that's where we're talking about in terms of loopholes. Now, I will say I disagree with the way the president exchange is in terms of immigration, and I didn't just start disagreeing. But I don't disagree with the ideology of what he's doing. But the way he's doing it, I sort of kind of disagree with it a little bit because it disdained the country and it disdained people who I think we need as a unit to stand in terms of that. So what, you know, as a country. So what happened is when he first did it 4 years ago, myself, I said, I wish the president would have won the passion of the people before he decided to go on with the process. Now, this is a process that Barack Obama was doing also. He was also deporting illegals because illegal is illegal. You're in somebody else's domain, you're eating off someone else's plate, and you're doing it illegally. And your children are basically accessing something that they have declared non-important to a group, and that's birthright citizenship. I mean, birthright citizenship belongs to legal citizens, people who come to the country that do it right and due diligence to become an American citizen, are in the jurisdiction thereof, which it states in the 15th and 14th Amendment. What happens is that when you're in that jurisdiction, it's not because you cross the Rio Grande and you step a leg across a line, it's that you're in our database as a citizen. And then government is not 5 years old, but they're acting like it in terms of these groups. And the reason why they're doing it is because we have white people or white supremacy or whoever owning businesses is getting them for cheaper labor. It might not be but $3 or $4 cheaper each job, but it adds up to be $1 million at the end of the year. So if it's cheaper, it's cheaper. So we got businessmen that are greeting, that is portraying the sanctuary, the integrity of our sanctuary in terms of law and business, according to what we have done, blood sacrifice, and who we really are. And also these groups coming here don't even know who we are as the American Negro, and they don't have to care, but they should because they're eating off our plate. And they are saying that we build and we do this. No, we've been building this damn country for 400 damn years. And everything is up and running now. Now, if you're such a good builder, why didn't you stay in Madagascar? Why didn't you stay in Guatemala? Because you're such a good, great builder, right? But you come here where everything is already developed in terms of opportunity, and then you finish building, and you grab a hammer and a nail or some bricks, and you start knocking stuff together. But you didn't really build the country. You didn't lay the foundation of the country so that it moves so adjacent to wealth and adjacent to power. You didn't do that. That wasn't you. And you don't know what you're saying. And so I wanted to let you know that I'm encouraging about this, but I want you guys to know that basically we can be friends with anybody. We can love anybody, but self-preservation has nothing to do with our friendship. And we need to understand the difference of that. So that's my purpose of doing the soundbite. Now, don't let these groups fool you. Black people that are out there that are unastute, that means unaware, not paying attention, stop flagging up to people and not understanding what's going on. Get your head in the content. We're in a different space and a different time. And I'm talking to everybody. I'm talking to X generation. I'm talking to millennials. And I'm also talking to the baby boomers. We all the same. And I'm talking to all religions. So we can understand where we at. We have a political crisis massively. And we need to understand how to do diligence and to do politics in terms of who we are and how we're positioned. And we're positioned and what against they're weaponizing other groups against us. And also, of course, white supremacy has always been a weapon against us from the day we stepped our foot on the soil. However, I will say that other groups are being constituent to white supremacy in terms of people's skin being one color, and to demise the experience of the American Negro. And we are coming to let them know that that is not acceptable in, according to us and our importance. And we're going to do it in a prestigious way. So I will say let's do politics, and I will say that Donald Trump is lesser evils in terms of what I've seen in the White House. But a lot of black people don't understand that. White people do. Some of them don't. But we got to wake each other up. So thank you for joining me. I just want to talk a little bit about immigration and what and how we should position ourselves in terms of that, because there's a law have been broken and people are getting treated in such a protected class way without really being a part of this society in terms of blood lineage. So that's what's really happening, and not being of this origin. But thank you for joining me. This is King Hart.